A new friend on Sodor.
At Netford Station, Thomas was just pulling in. Inside with James and Oliver.
Hi, how are you, Thomas?
Hello, guys.
What's wrong, Thomas? You look sad.
Well, you know something to do about Ashima?
Ashima? What should we know? Does she hate getting herself covered in coal?
No, not that.
Then what is it?
Well, next week it's her arrival on Sodor, and I'm just excited to see her again. She's my
my best girlfriend forever?
Oh, before I went to the Great Railway Show with James and the others, Ashima was the engineer I really accepted as a girlfriend after I was so mean to her.
When I was just an engine, I found it rather silly to see how many other girls I could meet. I had my trucks to shun, didn't know what I would ever need. Other engines at the Great Railway Show. But there was one girl that I cared for. I knew she would be there for me. My girlfriend, best friend forever. Like two peas in a pod, we did everything together. She taught me how to treat some elephant best friend forever. Never had a single fight in it. Just shared our hopes. We shared our dreams. I miss her more than I realize, it seems. Your best girlfriend, best friend forever. Like two peas in a pod, we did everything together. Cause she's so far away, oh, I wish she would stay. I miss her very much.
Don't cry, Thomas. We know you missed her very much. She missed you too.
I know.
I just miss her very much.
Excuse me, Thomas and Oliver. Come back over here.
Oops. Sorry, sir.
Technically, I cancelled next week for Ashima's arrival. In fact, she's arriving today.
Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god!
Was it just me, or did Thomas rush off in a hurry?
Thomas rushed to Brendan Dock so fast that he stopped sharply.
Then he saw Cranky unloading an engine he knew before.
The engine he competed at the Great Railway Show.
Oh.
Ashima! Thomas! Oh, it's very good to see you again, Ashima.
It's good to see you again too, Thomas.
How do you and Ashima know each other, Thomas?
Well, when we arrived at the Great Railway Show, I met Ashima. She has lots of bright colors. Until her truck was blocked, but I saved her life. In order, prepare myself to sacrifice.
Yes! We both won the trophies, and everyone at the Great Railway Show was happy until it was time for Thomas to go home.
Oh, Thomas, you can't just keep her here, even though you've met her.
I know, but it's great she's back.
Yes, Thomas, it is good to meet you.
Come on, Ashima, I'm going to show you the rest of Sodor.
Oh, Thomas, that will be nice.
This here is Titmus Sheds, where my friends and I go to rest. There is also stations, but there is also some stations like Nefford, where passengers can travel to any part of the island.
Wow, really?
Yep, and there's Brendan Docks, Kildane Station, Marin Station, the Shunting Yard, and everywhere else. That night, everyone was asleep. Ashima was sound asleep. Thomas, however, was breathing heavily as he slept. He was having a nightmare. Fast as he could. Soon he was at the edge of Brendan Docks. He tried turning backwards, but the thing that was chasing him was blocking his way. It was a demonic Ashima. Her bright colors had gone dark and her eyes were red with anger. Ashima, please listen. I'm sorry, said Thomas.
You sorry? After the way you treated me, I will never forgive you. You are never nice to me, so I'm returning the favor. Because of what you've done.
Oh gosh, I'm so screwed. Then Ashima started pushing Thomas towards the edge. The closer they got, the more frightened Thomas was.
Ashima, listen. I'm so very, very sorry for the way I treated you.
It's too late now.
With that.
Oh no.
With that, Ashima shoved Thomas off the edge and left him in the sea to rust and drown.
You get in! Get in!
Thomas's eyes went wider than a top hat as he woke up from his nightmare. Breathing heavily with a face drenched in sweat, he realized that he was in his own shed. Then he looked around to Ashima. She was very sound asleep. Her dark paintwork was gone, and her bright colors were back. Her eyes, though shut, were calm and peaceful. Slowly, tears fell from his eyes as he began to cry. It had been months ever since the railway show was over, and the international engines had returned to stay. Ashima had let the subject fly away, but it was nothing compared to what Thomas was going through ever since Ashima's arrival on Sunday yesterday. Over the past few weeks, Thomas had horrible nightmares of Ashima hating him and trying to kill him. Thomas's sobbing was all it took to wake Ashima up.
Thomas? Thomas, are you okay?
Ashima moved on to the turntable and switched tracks to face Thomas. All the while, Ashima saw Thomas, then Thomas saw Ashima's eyes. He saw that her eyes weren't filled with anger. They were filled with care, sorrow, and worry for him. Then he moved forward, smashing his lips onto hers, blessing her with a sweet kiss. Ashima was surprised at first. Then she returned the kiss. After a few hours, they broke off. Then Ashima could see Thomas blushing and crying at the same time.
Thomas? Are you okay?
Ashima, I'm sorry. I was so rude to you when you were left behind.
Ashima could see Thomas was feeling heart-chipped again, that he had the nightmare again. Then she moved herself and Thomas onto the turntable. Then they rolled into Ashima's shed. And after a few hours before the kiss, Ashima spoke.
Thomas, I could never hate or abandon you. I love you too much whenever we have our chips away. I love you.
Thomas thought he was dead.
He had just kissed the engine of his dreams, and now she was saying the words she'd never thought she'd say. Then he moved forward, smashing his lips onto hers, distantly telling her that he loved her too. All the while, the two engines started sleeping and kissing at the same time. And the next day, Thomas arrived at Knapford Station, and the Fat Controller had some devastating news.
Thomas, I have some news for you.
What is it, sir?
Ashima is going back to India tomorrow. Her day on Sodor is coming to an end.
Thomas was so sad. He was going to miss Ashima. Then he moved away. Then Thomas saw Ashima in the yard shunting trucks. Ashima could see that Thomas was sad and why.
Thomas, I'm sorry that you're sad.
I know, Ashima. It's hard to say goodbye. Then Twilight arrived on board Edward. She could see that Thomas was upset.
What's wrong, Thomas?
Ashima's leaving tomorrow. I'm going to miss her very much. Twilight felt very sorry for poor Thomas.
I know how hard my eye was like when I had to say goodbye to my friends in Canterlot.
What did you do?
I kept a picture of them. And then I didn't feel sad anymore. Just like how I had to say goodbye to my brother Shining Armor.
Thomas grew happy once again. Later, Ashima was loaded onto the boat to go back to India.
I hope you stay safe on the boat, Ashima.
I will, Thomas, and thanks for being so kind to me.
You're welcome, Ashima, and say hello to your friends in India for me.
I would.